Welcome back. Wall Street is weighing in by getting out of New York. More firms reportedly picking up and moving to places like Florida, saying New York City's tax burden, you know what, it's really bad for business. To the movie Wall Street 2 star Tom Belisis on if Palm Beach is becoming the new Wall Street. What do you make of this trend, Tommy?
Well, this is a trend that's happening all around the world, Liz. I mean, with governments overspending, you know, locally and nationally, looking for ways to pay their bills. So, I mean, they're just upping their tax rates, you know, in a very, very unprudent manner, which is causing a lot of people to leave these particular states and go to the Arizonas of the world, the Floridas of the world, the Nevadas of the world, the Texas of the world. I mean, the headlines that recently just hit with the pro golfer, Phil Mickelson, he's looking to leave California because of his tax situation and move to Nevada. Why? Because he'll save 13%.
Yeah, Tiger Woods is already gone from California, right? So are the Serena and Venus Williams sisters, right?
Absolutely.
From California. Go
Including
ahead.
Including now the former president, Sarkozy, looking to leave France and go to Great Britain. On top of the French actor, too, looking to leave France and go to Russia.
But you know what? It's not just hedge funds. That was the headline out today. It's not just hedge funds, Wall Street hedge funds leaving. I'm seeing big powerhouses like Goldman Sachs setting up shop, right, in low-tax states. You know, Raymond James, Deutsche Bank, T. Rowe Price. But the thing is, can these shops do business in those states?
You know, that's a great question, Liz. And I'll tell you, I think you can do business
anywhere. Wall Street, what I mean, trading business.
Sure,
Wall Street business.
I think you can do business anywhere, right? I mean, it's come down to the point that the regulatory environment is so burdensome that some of the costs that they have to, you know, lay out, you know, they look at it as a business expense, right? And they say to themselves, what's going to make us a profit versus lose us money to the shareholders? So they have to decide to make those tough choices and go to these states to save that money because maybe they can hire more people. Maybe they can open up multiple offices. Maybe they can do a lot more than they can do here in New York because of the fact that taxes are so high here.
Is anybody going to get a wake-up call about this in Albany or any other capital of any other high-tax state?
Liz, we certainly hope so because, you know what, I'll tell you one thing. This is how democracies fail. Not to say that this democracy is going to fail, but, you know, you have some people in some countries, look at, like, Dubai for a second, okay? I know that's, you know, out of, you know, our way here, but they have certain free zones that have zero taxes for 50 years.
50 years.
50 years, which attracts so much business to that particular center of the universe for people to come and do business because they're a business-friendly environment.
You know, let me ask you something, too. I mean, certainly Hurricane Sandy. Listen, downtown Manhattan, my brother-in-law is a fireman. I come from a long family of firemen. I've got firemen in my family. They've been saying, listen, the reason it flooded downtown is because it's basically landfill. I mean, the FDR Drive was built on landfill coming in from, you know, the Blitz from London, 28th to 34th Street. So it's underwater. I mean, Wall Street are saying, you know, saying to themselves, hey, another hurricane hits. We don't want to be flooded again. I mean, the Federal Reserve Central, you know, their offices got flooded down there. The big vaults got flooded down there, too. Go ahead.
You know, that was an aberration, Liz. I mean, a hurricane.
But does that factor into the decision-making? You know what? It's not worth it. We're going to get flooded. Let's just get out of here.
You know, I don't think so. You know, when 9/11 happened, you had a choice, right? Either to leave downtown.
But companies did leave downtown.
They did. But, you know, a lot of companies did make that decision to stay, right? Because you're not going to leave because, unfortunately, something, you know, like that would happen. Some people would leave, some people not, right? We decided to stay. But I don't think they're going to leave.
Did you stay for patriotic reasons?
That and also, you know, we love downtown and we believe, you know, that's a great area for businesses. And you know what? I'll stay downtown and I won't leave, but it's definitely smart to decide.
Are you thinking of leaving?
No, we're not. But we'll
would you ever leave to a low-tax state?
No, we definitely would look to set up another office in a low-tax state. Not move
that you would visit a lot, right?
That's absolutely right, especially Florida.
Right. Tommy Belisis, it's always a joy to be with you.
Same with
Star of Wall Street Movie 2. Wall Street 2, that was it.
Yeah. Wall Street 2.
All right, thank you, Tommy, for your time.